hitting on the flatulence. And they come on and they ask you, they say, if you're not going to Chicago, you're on the wrong flight. You know somebody. We said, we are here to celebrate homegoing mother. Know somebody.
Yeah.
And a lot of cheers.
All right, now.
Amen. We thank God for the Jackson, yeah, life, legacy. So if you're not here to celebrate her, you're in the wrong place. Come on. Let me get it started right. I'm going to just take a moment to give a praise to the Lord. Because somebody has to understand that we have not been to the Lord. We work with any of us. We thank God for this opportunity to see it as what we know is this.
Knowing that they were
stationed we know that
in various different
places. We don't cry as others do.
That
don't cry, just say not as others do.
We
know where mother is going. Yeah. She's going to a better place. No more pain, no more troubles, no more issues. She's going to a better place. So we know that she is in the hands of the Lord, and we thank God for that. We have a program. I'm Pastor Harrison from Seattle, Washington. They also come to church, and we spend some time with Mother as well as many of you have. And so we're just grateful as long as some of them here as well. So we're grateful. So we're going to follow the program as it has been laid out by the family. We're going to appreciate their wishes, but we want to celebrate and make sure that is the spirit and the attitude that we want to carry through this service. I want to ask if Apostle Bob Benton would come and lead us in a word of prayer.
Yeah. Let's pray. Father, we once again just want to say thank you. It is you that have created us and not we ourselves. Father, we thank you for this day. For this is the day that we just want to say thank you because it's a brand new day. Not only is it my birthday, Lord, 75 years of life. I just want to thank you. If nobody else want to thank you, I want to thank you. We thank you for this day. Thank you for your presence here today. Lord, we've heard it that this is a celebration of life. We know that in you we do have life and we have it more abundantly. So, Father, we pray that you would just touch every heart today. Touch, Lord, with only the touch that you can touch. Some, Lord, may be feeling the sorrow, but Lord, Jesus wants you to turn that sorrow into joy, because the joy of the Lord is our strength, and with joy we can draw water out of your magnificent well of salvation. So bless this time. Lord, everything that we say and do, Lord, let it be pleasing in your sight. Now, Father, we pray that you would just touch the family in a very special way. Touch even now. Know that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. We know that this is a time for joy and celebration and be happy with you, Father. So bless every word tonight. In Jesus' holy name we pray.
Amen. We want to be sure that we take a moment to say that to the family. We have our deepest condolences and we lost on your level. And we know these are not easy times, but pray that you have the Lord on your side and we will see you through these difficult times. And as Pastor Ida, a battle to come and to read these two scriptures. The Old Testament, Psalm 91, 1 through 3, the New Testament, Romans 8 and 28. That's the battle.
Amen. And again, we're here to celebrate Mother Jackson. Amen.
Amen.
Mother Jackson was the most sad. Mother Jackson was the praise worshiper.
Amen.
And she worshiped God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So I just celebrate Mother tonight, today. Amen. And I'm going to read Psalms 91. And it said, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Surely, did you say surely?
Surely.
Hallelujah. He said, deliver me from the snare of the fowl and from the noisome pestilence. Amen.
Amen.
So Mother Jackson has been delivered. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so I'm going to read Psalm 8 and 28. Hallelujah. And how many of us know this? Amen. And we know that all things, hallelujah, work together for good to those who are what? Who love.
Mm-hmm.
And to those who are called according to his purpose, his plan. Amen. Can we just give God praise? Thank you for your prayer.
Let me do this real quick. I can't get it to come too much.
We're going to have the obituary be read by Cynthia's sins.
I'm trying to turn it down, but I can't get it to my Bluetooth.
Bless the Lord. Oh, my soul.
Okay.
Lottie Cornelia Grady Jackson was born to Harvey and Luella Anderson Grady in DeKalb, Mississippi on July 23rd, 1933. She was an excellent student and graduated May 5th, 1950 from the Whistler High School in DeKalb, Mississippi. Lottie relocated to Chicago, Illinois, where she sang first soprano in the Milton Bronson and Thompson Community Choir. She met and married the late Alfred Jackson Jr. There were seven children born to this dream. She loved flowers, plants, and gardening. Her dad was an avid baker, passed his baking skills on to her and her siblings. There were many times when her yeast crumbs, banana puddings, cakes, sweet potato pies, and pecan pies were enjoyed at various functions. She was a skilled Southern cook. Lottie insisted on a clean kitchen and an immaculate house. In 1972, Lottie moved to Tacoma, Washington, and attended Calvary Methodist Church under Reverend Snow. She later joined Allen AME, actively participating for 30 plus years in the Women's Auxiliary, Sunday School, Bible Study, and the Chapel Choir. She was an active community member, taking part in Habitat for Humanity and the citywide Messiah group. Lottie always watched for ways to help the people she met. As her health and mobility changed, Mother Lottie began attending Unity Church in Tacoma under the leadership of Bishop Lenal Battle and Pastor At Unity Church, she was loved, cherished, and spiritually nurtured, enjoying the preached word, open praises, Bible studies, and Christian fellowship. Lottie moved to Texas in 2018 and attended Spirit Fellowship Church in Minnesota, Texas, under the leadership of Bishop D.A. Davis and Minister Loretta Davis. She loved singing the songs of Zion, Mother Lottie continuously encouraged her children and the generations below to walk in faith. She made it a point to be at every birth and graduation of her descendants. She transitioned in Texas on November 25th, 2022. Her parents preceded her in death. Lottie is survived by her younger sister, Aura Grady Allen, of Washington in California. Lottie and Aura were the last two surviving siblings of the Stephen Grady and Charlotte Hall Grady family, second generation. Lottie was also preceded in death by her nine siblings, Willie Mae Reed, Stephen Grady, Elizabeth Rose, Woody D. Grady, Gussie E. Johnson, Eloise Butler, Mildred Deuce, Dora Lee Grady, and Louise Grady. Lottie was also preceded in death by her husband, Alfred Jackson Jr., and two sons, Spinner Jackson and Dave Grady Keith Jackson. She will forever be cherished by her children, Leonard Demetra Jackson, Alfred Jackson III, Lavina Brady Key, Patricia Davis, Charisse Jackson, and Angela Rambo Timothy, and her sister Orin Brady Allen. Fond memories will be held by her 18 grandchildren and 24 great grandchildren. Numerous relatives and friends mourn her passing, but are consoled by the knowledge that she is resting. This lesson is meant to you all.
I'm sorry, we will celebrate her very good. We have to get a great legacy. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Excellent. Very well done. Yeah, very well done. Appreciate the time that it takes to do that type of presentation. Get the just right ones. Flow just at the right time. Amen. Shows the love that Son we had experienced for this great. Great moment. Notice we have Harrison's have a standing reunion in 2 years. As I look through our family, I see resemblance. Someone said one time, I said, oh, we have some strong bloodlines. And I noticed the same thing with David Jackson as the other names in the family. You could look at, as they came in, and I was in the room out there, and they came in, she's one of them. just that kind of look, the chin, the eyes, the nose, everything, you know, it's right. And together, you can tell. Amen. So that's a beautiful thing to have someone in your family that's so loved and appreciated, not just by the family, but by probably every church that she ever went to. She left a mark.
Amen.
She left a stamp. I said earlier, she wasn't at Pentecostal Covenant that long, but she was the kind of woman that when I got to preaching, she got to talk. Amen. She was speaking. Amen. And you hear someone know, we like that support. And somebody supporting us, we're good people. We're equal. Amen. And that's kind of the type of woman that she was. She had a variety of looks, a variety of churches that she was. The issue isn't the church so much as that she gave her support. She just wasn't a member. She was a member of the team. She was supported. I want to take a moment to allow the patriarch, this Grady family, or Grady now. Marks this time of the hiring of the new man. Go for it. We're wrong. We'll go. Yes. To what she will do. I was trying to think of something that I needed to share, make a person know value. I got a card from her one time that says, I made a decision with the children to be friends. We chose to be friends. In spite of all the discouragements that we had, the disagreements we had, we chose. I thank God for all the
trip to Texas 2 years ago, or
last year.
I don't recommend a road trip for a person my age coming from California to Texas. I recommend a beautiful trip. The valuable time and experience together is etched in my head. You know, I'm not sad. I'm worked at trying to be thankful for the years that we've had, times that we've had, the sorrows that we've shared, the joys that we've shared. Those are memories that we want to think. I want to say this to sisters. You have to laugh when you got to love them. Times when there's going to be things that's going on, but stay close to the sisters. Stay close. We're the same clothes, we share shoes, we share jackets, we share this, we share that. So I'm going to miss you, Tina. I'm not going to miss you in a way that might seem strange, because believe it or not, just after she transitioned, she came into my spirit. I'm not going to say what my pet name was.
Naughty.
You better not.
Naughty.
But she came to me and she said, you let my daughters tell this. I said, okay. Sisters, daughters, nieces. That's why I stayed back in the gym. But Tina, I don't have people in glory saying, you didn't want to do something about this. But thank God for the years. She was a good cook, a good baker. I'm not a good baker, I'm not a good. She was a good cook. These rolls were the great right now. She loved clothes, she loved travel. Attend as many family reunions as we could together and came together. She loved family. She did love family. See that? When I look over around and see all these babies and grandbabies and stuff together, you're still here. You're still here. I am the last surviving member of my mommy's family.
Connected to
this. And I don't know how long I'll be here, but I'm going to say, share this. It's been a good trip. It's been a long road travel, it's been a good trip. Thank God for the yards. Who knows you've done a good job? Done a tremendous job. Thank God for you. So I know that's just a little bit of bloodline, DNA. These are memories that will never fade. There's a song I won't sing. She was a better singer. She was a better singer. I sang to my professional leader, she sang, and she was a better singer than I want to believe it or not. The song goes like, when you come to the end of a perfect day and sit along with your loves, the times ring out with the carol ring, the joy that the day has brought. You think what the end of a perfect day may mean to a tired heart, the sun goes down with the flame. Well, this is the end of a perfect day and the end of a journey, too. This is a good journey, a long journey. 88 and 89 years, that's a long time. We used to have thought that it's big and strong, and I wish this kind of truth, a memory that's painted this perfect. Come with that one, everything. We find at the end of a perfect day, so.
Amen.
It's a pastor in the future. I can appreciate
couple of those things that she said sit in my spirit. And I said, that will preach. And I'm going to take a few things. There you go. We also have some friends that have been asked to give remarks and ask them to come one after the other. I believe it's Bertha Reed and Deb Todd.
Today, I met Miss Jackson at Alamein Church. She asked for a ride home, and we were surprised to know that we lived only about two blocks away. And ever since then, it's been 48 years, Miss Jackson. We were friends. We were true friends to each other. I had the opportunity to see her November 22nd of this year. I was in Texas visiting with my sister, and before I left Washington State, I told her I have to see Miss Jackson. I went to the facility where I thought she was living, and they told me that she was with her daughter. So I made it a point to go over to see her. And I was told, they said, Miss Reed, she sleeps quite a bit, and she may not recognize you. But when I went into the room, I said, Miss Jackson, this is Mrs. Reed. And she raised her arm. She says, oh! And I knew that the Lord had let her know that I was there, because I had told her over the phone. I said, I'm coming to Texas and I'm going to see you. We had many, many times, beautiful times together over the years. We were true friends. We laughed together. We cried together. We had sorrow in our lives together. But one thing I remembered, Miss Jackson, she loved to shop, thrift shop. I am not a thrift shop. But I learned to enjoy trip shopping with her, because you know, when you're true friends, you do things with each other that you may not enjoy. I remember traveling to Levensburg. This is one thing I will always cherish within my heart. We traveled to Levensburg together, and she says, oh, look at those moon rings. I said, moon ring? She said, you know the ones that change colors. We should get one. And I'm wearing mine today. I'm wearing mine today. I told the Lord last night, I said, I need to find that ring. And I thought this is going to be a struggle. But you know, the Lord is good. And he directed me to where that ring was. So I thank the Lord for Miss Jackson's friendship. We always called each other Miss Jackson, if you wonder, but that's just something that you get. She called me Miss Green, I call her Miss Jackson. I love her children so dearly. I love her sisters, her nieces, and we talk all the time. And one thing I know, that is, you don't have to see your friends every day. You don't have to live in the same state where they're living. But when you talk, you know that friendship is there. And I will cherish her friendship forever and ever. And I thank the Lord, and I thank your family for sharing your mother, your sister, your niece, your grandmother with me, because truly, I love Miss Jackson.
Hello, my name is Deborah Todd. I live in Shoreline. And as you may have guessed, I'm also a friend of Lottie's. Chrissy, you just said everything. I'm serious. Lottie was such a good friend. So how did we get to know each other? We've been friends for about 25 years. Lottie worked in healthcare, and she came to help care for my parents. And their care became too much for me. And that period lasted for about 4 years. During that time, our lives literally were interwoven with big life events. One day, she came in through the door, and I have to do this because you have to see how she did it in this year. Comes in and she's going, "I'm great! I'm great!" And I said, "Why? What is it?" Her first great grandchild had been born that day. And she was over the moon. She just kept dancing around the house, going, "Great!" And she really was great. She really is great. And she was grateful also that her husband, Alfred, got to meet his great grandchild. So she became a great grandmother. She became a widow. I lost my dad. So my mother became a widow. And Lottie and my mother would sit up late at night talking. I mean, literally to like 2 or 3 in the morning. But our friendship did not end after my mother passed. We continued to be friends. I held dinners in my home, monthly dinners in my home, and Lottie came and brought Laura and Eloise and Pat and her friends. And, you know, our friendship continued. I'm part of the Lottye's of Shoreline. Every year we hold a soul food dinner at the end of February. And to honor Black History Month, and Lottie would come and bring her family and bring her friends. And it was there that Sherry was the poet laureate for the boys. We talked on the phone all the time. I mean, we truly became friends, really good friends. And when she moved to Texas, we continued to talk on the phone for hours at a time. I'm very grateful to the family. Thank you for letting me join the Zoom in July for her birthday. I last spoke with her in August by phone. Called her in September. She didn't answer. She didn't call back. A weeks ago, the doctor called to say that Lottie was transitioning. And the next day, Aurora called and said Lottie had passed. And so, Lanitra asked me if I could just say a few words today. I love Lottie very, very dearly. I miss her terribly. She was a great friend. One other thing, we had birthdays in July, so we had a July Baby's Birthday Club. Every year, we always celebrate. I'll miss her for those. So thank you very much for letting me say a few words, and my love to all of you. Love you. I love you. I miss you. Thank you.
I shall wear a crown. When it's all over,
Amen. Amen. Leave you with a tell, if you don't mind. If there is second liberty. I think one of the greatest things for the Lottye would have wanted to see the entire family set through the walk of the Lord. To know who Jesus is. With that, we're going to dedicate this two verses, one verses. It's for those that already know him. The other verse speaks to those that may be on their way to him. 2 Corinthians, verse number 5, chapter 5, verse number 1. Verse 17. For we know that if our earthly body, for we know if our earthly house, this tabernacle, were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Love to know him. This is how you will end up. Verse 17, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things, somebody say all things, are passed away. And behold, all things have become new.
Yes.
All things are of God, who has reconciled us unto himself by Jesus Christ and has given to us ministry. Reconciliation.
Yes.
I'll end right there. Pastor. Let's see. Yeah, Pastor Rachel James will come. Unity Christian Ministries.
I'm coming to you with a resolution from Unity Christians. The now pastor I'm Dabo, where other Dabbins attendance prior to going to Texas. And I just wanted to say I was thinking about this on last night. My grandmother passed on the December 1st of last year. And so as I was sitting there thinking, I said, Mom and Mother Jackson seats were right next to each other, and no one had sat in their spot since they left. So I was thinking about that, I said, so they are now in the heavens, and we are retiring their seats. Amen. And so I just appreciate Mother Jackson. And I appreciate the friendship that her and Mom shared. It was really important to me. For both of them being widows, it was they needed each other at the same time. So it's just their friendship. Amen?
Amen.
Saturday, December 10, 2022, resolution in loving memory, a mother, Lottye Jackson. According to his tender mercy, God, who is infinite in his wisdom, has seen fit to move our beloved mother, Lottye Jackson, onto her reward in the heavens on Friday, November 25th, 2022. Whereas Mother Lottye Jackson was devoted to God, family, and the work of the ministry, we honor her legacy of love. Whereas our beloved Mother Lottye Jackson demonstrated faithfulness, courage, enthusiasm, vision in loving and helping God's people. She was a servant and loved the church. God used her in a multitude of ways.
Whereas Mother Lottye Jackson was faithful in her commitment to the Lord and her special gift of making those around her feel important and like family, which has enriched the lives of many. Therefore, we be it resolved that we honor and celebrate the life of this great woman of God, Mother Lottye Jackson. We will miss her, but never forget her as we humbly submit to this divine will of God. Be it further resolved that we embrace and support her family in the homegoing of her beloved, of our beloved Mother Jackson. Mother, grandmother, wife, sister, and friend, be it also resolved that a copy of this resolution will be given to the Jackson family and a copy will be placed in the church archives this December 10th, 2022. When it's all over, we would like you to remember, in case there's times when you just need some cheer, in case there's problems you would like us to hear, in case there's a favor you would like us to do, we're here if you need us to help you through. Respectfully submitted, Bishop Linnell and Pastor Ina Battles, Senior Pastors of Unity Christian Ministries, and Sister Beverly Member, our church administrator. Thank you.
Come on, it's a celebration. Come on.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We appreciate that. I want to bring to the podium a pastor that I just met today. He is spirit, he's a fine pastor, and bishop. Now,
I want to thank God for this occasion. Praise God, it is a joyous occasion. Praise God, we know that Mother Jackson was a worship.
Yes, she was.
When we begin to worship in church, she just swayed her hands. And she just had a good time to praise God. Thank God. But we're gathered here today to say our goodbyes and to celebrate and appreciate the life and times of our dear Mother Lottye Jackson. I want to acknowledge the family, praise God, and just let you know it's okay to mourn, and all the friends, family to mourn. Some people say, why mourn? Because it's a place, it's a human emotion that we mourn. Matter of fact, mourning is needful. Folks that don't mourn, they keep it inside to find an exploding lake. And so, shortest verse in the Bible is Jesus wept.
Yes.
He cried because of his friend Lazarus. Yes. So that authorizes us to also grieve. It's a process and we need to do it. So it's okay to cry, to grieve. It's okay. And somebody said, well, how long is that going to last? I'm going to grieve. I lost my mother a few years ago. She went to be with the Lord, transitioned, and I find myself waking up today, some days, almost 3 years later, and thinking about her, and tears filling my eyes. So only you and God can determine the time frame, praise God. But every time I cry, God would still come me on. That's the type of God we serve. It's okay to grieve. It's okay to grieve. Praise God. Who Mother Jackson was, you've heard testimonies, and it's a testimony of all those that are gathered here that she touched lives. She touched so many lives. And she wore different hats and different roles. So she was a daughter. She was a sister. She was a wife. She was a mother. She was a grandmother. And she was a great grandmother.
Yes.
She was a beloved auntie. She was a dear friend to me. But I think the most greatest thing that she was, I believe, the greatest thing that she was a believer.
Yes.
She believed in the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's not leave it there. She believed in all of you as well.
Yeah.
She believed the best for us, for everyone, praise God. I remember, praise God, the first time I met her, she just lit up. She was just, she had a glow about her. Her smile, praise God, just kind of pulled you in, you know, praise God. She was a dear heart and a sweetheart. Mother Jackson is, and I say is because I'll get to that in a minute, the transition, it don't end there. We say she was, but she is. As a celebrity, the state of being famous for celebrating. How many 85 plus people do you know that love you? Come on, somebody, you count them on your hands, praise God. There are a whole lot of folk that get to that age that you even know that she's here, praise God. So that puts them in a category of being a celebrity, famous, and they need to be celebrated. But Mother Jackson was a celebrity, not because of her age, but more so because of her love for others. She was one of God's shining stars. Praise God. She was a shining star. She never changed. She anytime, and you know, she'd be young folk to church. I don't know how. Young folk grabbing it, and she heard Mother Thomas. They must have Mother Thomas was a 90 plus, and Mother Jackson was right there. And maybe she'd be in church when the young folk come in. That's an example of faithfulness. But know that she was one of God's true shining stars. Heard the testament and the stories of everyone she came into contact with, blessed God. Her love for the Lord was manifested and shown in her love for people, all people. It has been said that love is what love does. Mother Jackson's love was always active and on display as she served the Lord, loving and serving people, her family, and others. She was friendly, entreating, and a pleasure to be around. That was one of the things, a unique gift she had, too. She could talk to anybody. You know, I seen her talk to young folk, old folk, middle-aged folk, because she was so entreatable. I mean, that's a quality everybody don't have. Sometimes we find it difficult to even talk to our neighbors that we see every day. Praise God. But she had that quality that God had blessed her with. She testimony. Mother Jackson loved the Lord and was a true servant. She always had a testimony for the Lord. Now, word of God says we will come by the blood of the Lamb and the words of our testimony. Do you know your testimony helps you to overcome? But there's no testimony without a test.
All right.
And you need to know that Mother Jackson had a lot of tests in her life that she passed. And once she passed a test, she could have a testimony. Then you got something to say. How many of y'all know when you begin to say something for the Lord, God begin to do something for you?
Yeah, amen.
So Mother Jackson had a powerful testimony for the Lord. She was a minister. Somebody said, well, she didn't take the podium on the pulpit. Oh, you know, all ministers don't take the podium in the pulpit. You see? The definition of a minister is one who gives aid or service. That's a minister. One who gives aid or service. Stop and think about all the lives she intertwined with and how she gave aid, encouragement, and service. That's a minister. But one of the powerful ministry is the ministry of presence. Yeah. Every time I look over in church and see a mom sitting there and encourage me, I just wanted to shout. Because the ministry of presence has an effect on all of us. We're here because somebody was present in our life.
True.
If they weren't there, you probably wouldn't be here today. Praise God. But it's because of that presence. That presence makes a difference in somebody's life. It makes a difference in somebody's life. Love is validated by the time you spend with loved ones. Love is what love does. Praise God. Now, we say, and a lot of folks are looking at, she's not here, we don't have her with us anymore. But you understand that when we leave here, it's not the ending. It's truly the beginning.
Yes.
It's not over. It's not ending. Mother Jackson transitioned.
That's right.
That's all she did. She Amen. Just, somebody say like the Jeffersons, and she moved uptown. You know? So when you understand that, but I know as young people, and depending on where you are in your relationship with your theology and with the Lord, we don't understand. So we think death is final and it's so traumatic and it's just right there. But and we understand, we think, watch, we think that it's an anomaly. We think it's strange. We think it's distant. We think it's odd, but it's not.
It's not.
It's not. There's war every single day on this planet. Over 180,000 people give up the ghost.
It's not something.
Every single day on this planet, and that's on a good day. We got a earthquake or something. It's even more than that. So it's not strange.
Amen.
It's just distant for us, even though we never realize how close it is to us.
And we don't want to think about our own mortality in a morbid sense, but we need to think about it as where we're going to spend eternity.
Amen.
That's
amen.
Very, very important. I see Mother Jackson, she had her she may not have had the 401k, but she had a 301J. And that's her ticket to heaven, which is God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, and J, Jesus, was her access. So she had her 301J in place. Mother China plan is for her. 401k only takes you so far. Jesus. And she knew Jesus. She loved the Lord with all of her heart. But I want to just dwell a little bit on death and time, just for a minute. There are many philosophical and theological discussions and arguments about religion and God. It don't take much. All you got to do is folks telling you they don't believe that. It don't matter if you believe it or not. You still going to leave here.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
You're going to give up the ghost. It is going to be all over. The Bible says appointing the man to die once and then the judgment. So even though there's uncertainties about our human physical mortality, at some point, everybody under the sound of my voice. I want to be morbid. Let me put it this way. 100 years from today.
Well,
check out there. That's back. But I just want to hear a certain group of folk. 50 years from today. I know I won't be here 50 years from today. I'm 71 years old. 50 years from today, I'm going to be gone. And so wherever you are, you have to understand that there's just a matter of time. Just a matter of time. That's where I want to go with my scripture reading, as a matter of fact. Time. The definition of time is an opportune moment. That's where we live in time. God lives in eternity. It's hard for us to comprehend from time to eternity, but time will take you to the disco and eventually just take you to Costco or Thrifco when you get older, praise God. But time can't take you to eternity.
Amen.
You see, you have to transition into eternity.
Come on now, that's crazy.
But God gives us all a certain amount of time. Time for what? For the purpose of life is to know God and make him known.
All right, now.
If you've been searching and wondering and looking, and you wonder why you've never arrived or never came into it, because you were created for a purpose, and that purpose is to know God.
Amen.
It is to know God. I remember when I was young, it seemed like it took forever for a year. I mean, it took like Christmas never came around, but this year was the fastest year of my life. I thought it was last year, but the older I get, the faster the years come.
Yeah,
I said,
yeah,
why is that? I thought it was closer to the end than we are to the beginning.
All right.
You see, we only have so much time. Time is a commodity. You see, if we take it for granted, you can't create more time. We just got to stop wasting time and take the time to improve.
That's good.
This is what the scripture reads. For everything there is a season, a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up with that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to rejoice, a time to cast away and a time to gather together. There is a time for everything under the sun. Now, let's admit we take it for granted that time is going to continue.
True.
Those from old school, you remember a song, I think it was the Rolling Stones, say, time, time, time is on my side. Y'all remember that song?
Yeah, oh, time ago.
But it will come a time when time won't be on your side.
Hey, well.
It will come a time. It will not be on your side.
Amen.
That's why we've got to make the most of time.
Yes.
The Bible says that it's an opportune moment. That's the thing I appreciated about your mom, Mother Jackson's soul, is because she appreciated moments. She relished in the moments. That's why she wanted to be with family and with friends. It's the moments Because sometimes we don't appreciate the moment until it becomes a memory.
Come on now. Amen.
And then it's, I wish I would have.
Yes, yeah.
Rather than taking the time to do it at that time.
Yeah.
Realizing that our earthly life is a frailty and death is a certainty. We have to understand that. There were so many, especially with so many things that are going on, with the pandemic and all the stuff that's going on. There are so many people meeting here. We'll be at another homegoing celebration on Monday, myself, my wife. But the beauty of that is, we're going to folks are safe.
All right, now.
I've got a lot of music.
The folks
that
call on
the Lord, that is a celebration.
It surely is.
See, we do the electric slide down here, they do the Holy Ghost slide.
Oh, my God.
Having a good time. You don't have to worry no more. You don't have to worry about your mood no more. God healed her and took her home.
Hey.
She was a passion. She was home in the Lord. Because everything that belongs to God, God brings on.
Hallelujah. That's all right. That's good.
That's why you want to belong to God before you meet Him.
Yes.
That's why you want to know Him before you meet Him.
Amen.
If you want to hear, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord. How many want to hear that? Because none of you said you were talking to God. Lord, you don't want to know that, but that's why you have to seize the urgency of the moment. The urgency of the moment is that we have a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ now.
Amen. Now. Right now.
I mean, when I was young, I didn't care about that because I thought I was going to live forever.
Well,
but God showed me some young graves in the graveyard, just like some tall ones in there.
Yeah.
You know, death is no respect of person.
True.
And Martin Luther King called it life's final common denominator.
Oh,
my. It's a direction we don't all go. But see, the beauty of that is if your bags are packed and you're ready to go,
right now.
If somebody told me they was taking you to New York City, would you pack your bags and be ready? Yeah. You would be. When you know you're going on a trip, it makes sense to have your bags packed.
Right. Go ahead, that's a good one. That's really
packed.
Good. That's good.
But you didn't trip because your bags was packed. I'm glad to be there. But I know we young that go by us because we look for those Friday night specials in the bar.
Oh,
you
right.
Know what I'm saying? Yeah. When we look for the where's the party over here, party over there.
That's true.
One day you go, if God bless you to continue to live in, you ain't gonna be able to get to the party, but what you gonna do when you get there?
Well,
at some point you got the tool. The word of God says when I was a child, I did childish things. But at one point, I had to grow up and realize that there is greater things to see.
Yeah.
And watch this, because your life is greater than just your life.
Amen.
Which is so evident by Mother Jackson's life. Look at all the lives she touched.
Right.
Her life was greater than just her life.
Yeah.
Amen. Your legacy goes forward by how you live.
Yes, amen.
And I'm going to be honest, you can't live right without God.
Amen.
I tried.
All right.
You can't live right without God. You can try your best.
Sure can.
And still in this.
Amen. Really.
You can do all that you can do that you think you know, uh-huh, and still miss it.
Come on.
That's why we need Jesus, the need for Jesus in our life.
Amen.
You see, because when I receive Jesus as Lord and Savior of my life, the Bible says I've been justified.
Come on now.
Justified, never done that. Go ahead. Yeah, amen. And I see, here's the thing, that I embrace that. Embrace that.
Oh, yeah.
You see, because here's the thing. Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor.
Yeah.
And a heavy laden. I don't mean to step on no toe, but he said, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Yeah.
And when we get the knowledge of that, when we get a revelation of that, we realize and understand I need God. Because one day I'm going to leave him.
All
right.
When I wake up and open my eyes, mm-hmm. I want to hear the words of the Lord say, enter into the joy of the Lord.
Yes.
We live all of our lives living beneath sometimes our privileges. Because sometimes of the poverty and economy and so many things that affect our lives.
Amen.
But the Bible says, Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for
take
you.
Take your time. Amen.
That where I am, there you may be also.
Thank you. Thank you.
Another scripture said, I have not seen, you have not heard, neither did it into the hearts of man the things that God has prepared for those that love him. Can you match on this earth what God has prepared for?
Not at all.
Oh, look at somebody say, I don't miss that. I don't want to miss that. I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to that. They would say, well, we look at time and as a long time, 90 years. The Bible says 1,000 years is one day to God. So if you do the math and break it down, 83 years is about 2 hours to God.
Come on now.
Somebody.
Come on now. Amen.
But you don't want to walk it for the Bible says all I do is
like a
exactly. Now, young folk don't believe that when you get my age.
Well,
it seems like I just got out of college a few years ago.
Well,
how did I get here?
Yeah.
Where did it go?
Yeah.
Where did it go? I said, God, help me.
Well,
God said, I am here with you.
Yes.
Watch it, I'm telling you, you ain't gonna be here, man. I used to have jelly curls.
Oh.
Somebody say, I used to have long hair, but now I'm longing for hair. Time will change you. But God gives us a chance and an opportunity.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
To know him.
Yes.
God loves you more than you can imagine.
Say that.
You can't imagine how much God loves you.
Amen.
He's waiting to have a relationship with you.
Yeah.
And that's one of the things I know Mother Jackson wanted for her family more than ever. Mm. That they know the Lord.
Yeah.
That they know the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Praise God. I'm just about done.
Yeah.
I believe Mother Jackson would have me to say today to all those that are present here, to say, go the straight and narrow way that leads to life.
Yeah.
I know a lot of things look like it's life, but just because it's a crowd and a lot of bleep mean everything that glitters ain't gold.
So it is.
Everything that greedy grass.
Yeah, so it is.
And so we have a lot of things out there that deceptions that we get caught in, especially as young, because we're looking for a certain type of life. But when you live for the Lord, you are among the rich and the famous.
Isn't that amazing?
When you live for the Lord, nothing. Have the best, maybe not here on this planet,
uh-huh. But
you have to remember, you just feel what's passing through. For how much longer will we be here? I believe she would have me to say to you, Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life.
Amen.
How do you know? Because I tried another way.
Come on.
A lot of my life.
Yeah.
I didn't get saved until I was 33 years old. You know, you can do a lot of skirt chasing, drugging, and doping, and a lot of stuff by the time you get 33.
Yeah, that's true.
But thank God I had a mother.
Amen.
That was praying for me. And God heard a prayer. And somebody invited me to church.
Well,
and something happened one day in church. And my life changed. Yeah, I went home and I pulled out the alcohol and crushed the weed and changed.
Amazing. Hallelujah.
God will do the same thing.
Yeah.
For any and everybody.
Amazing.
And I believe she would have me to tell you, follow the way, the truth, and the life. I believe she would have you to say, love one another.
Yeah.
As Christ loved the church.
Yeah.
I believe she would have you to say, if you love what you have everything you need.
Oh, right. Hallelujah.
I would believe she would have me to say to you, Alpha, that she was proud of you.
Oh.
Your mother loved you. She would say to her daughter, she was loving you. She enjoyed talking about her family. She enjoyed talking about her family. She was an inspiration. She was such an inspiration in the church. and just to be around her. She would go home with us sometime after church, and she would just sit there and laugh and talk, and she, we would have an awesome time. An awesome time. She was a beautiful, beautiful individual. God blessed her. Praise God. I believe she would have me to say, don't be weary in your well-doing.
Well.
She would say, don't worry about me no more.
Well.
You don't have to worry about her no more. Oh, she probably come and step. She would be slow. I guarantee she come and step.
Well.
Somebody say, she's healed complete.
Come on now. That's awesome. Awesome. Amen.
God is good. Yes, God is the same thing.
Awesome. Yes.
Everybody. He's no respected person.
No, he is.
He's just waiting to have a relationship with you.
Yeah.
That's
amen.
What he's doing.
Amen.
So what Mother Jackson did, she stepped out of time and stepped into eternity.
Come on now.
Because the Bible says to be absent from the body
is
to be present with the Lord.
It's written.
She's probably watching this service right now saying, oh, that both of my babies over my head. Oh, I can't wait till they get here.
Oh, my Lord.
Praise God. But know that you're blessed.
Yes. Yes.
God has sent you leaders,
yes.
Family members, and patriarchs that set the example for you.
Beautiful.
Praise God. Follow in their footsteps. You will be blessed. Your children will be blessed.
Yeah.
Your grandchildren will be blessed.
It's written.
It says, from generation to generation to generation.
Yeah.
So you're already blessed. Don't even know it.
Look at that. Look at that. Awesome.
I believe she would have me to say that not to harm me in trouble. I know she would have me to say, fight a good fight.
Yeah.
Finish your course. Keep your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. You will see me in heaven. Mm. We said that a long life. Let's just live a long life. That's a long life. That's a long life. Seniors that live for the Lord, they just seem to keep on going.
Mm.
That's a blessed life.
Yes.
I know the definition of blessed is
tell me.
Anything dedicated to God.
Hallelujah.
That's all. Praise God. But it's been said that a long life is not good enough. And a good life is not long enough.
Well,
but a saved life is more than enough.
Hallelujah.
God bless you with an awesome example. Bless you. And I really believe this, that a mother's love.
I love that. That's beautiful.
I believe I miss my mother. I remember growing up, I used to go to jail about twice a week.
Oh, bless your heart.
They used to come get me when I was a minor.
Oh, bless
you. When I became 18, my dad said, well, that boy looks like it there. Maybe leave there for a while.
Oh, my Lord. My Lord.
But, Paul, let's look at that boy.
All right now. Hallelujah.
Mothers are special.
Yes, we are.
They are very, very special. So love each other and appreciate each other and celebrate each other. You know, a lot of times we tolerate and not celebrate.
That's true now. That's
but
true.
Celebrate the relationships and those people that love you. Those people that love you will be a part. If they love you, they'll be a part of your life.
Yes.
Yeah.
I used to wonder why my son would listen to their friends when they listen to mom and dad. But that's how young people do. You see, the friends that they grew up with, they don't even see them no more. They don't know where they are. They care less about them. But here we are, lifting them up. That's what family do for each other. Praise God. So, to God be the glory. We love you. We love you. We love you. Anything we can do for any of you, let us know. We loved your mother. I tell you, we really loved her. We did it last year. If we were there, we needed to see her go. We really did. You know, we really did. I think my wife went down and seen her twice when she was in Texas. But she was a jewel. She was truly a jewel, and her legacy is right there. So to God be the glory. Be blessed. We love you.
To say that again.
Yeah.
She's already prepping this. I was going to take my stab. Not the unshelled. Here is what we are announcing.
Thank you. So at this time, we want to thank everyone who offered prayers, words, deeds of kindness, acts of visitation during our hour of grief. May God richly bless all of you. Thank you, truly.
Oh, thank you.
Concludes the round for today. But it ends with a word of prayer. The family, the gifts as a family, appreciates and is assisting. Family appreciates all of you that are here and then come and celebrate with them. Moral service only of their dear mother, grandmother. It's just nice. It's been nice to come to celebrate. So much you have held in the highest room. So God bless you. So if they have some refreshments, and we will be leaving first, they will have some refreshments over. It's fixed in a COVID style, so you can take it with you or just stay in the chat with the family if you think it's not. So, Ash, if you would stand and ask the family if they were exiting. Thank you so much. Put your hands together for the family. We thank God for the ministry, casual ministers, pastors, and bishops here today. So we bless you with prayer, God. Spot upon you, children. Pray, Father, bless you. These that are here, give them safety as they leave this place. Let them hold your presence in us. Bless the very special one, Lord. Well, thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless.
You're welcome to unmute. You're welcome to unmute. Thank God for each and every one of you. Praise the Lord. I'm going to keep this open. So if you would like to exchange greetings with each other, you're able to do so. You are now permitted to unmute. God bless you, man. God bless you. Good to see you. Thank you. You're welcome to unmute. You're welcome to unmute if you would like to chat with each other. You're welcome to do so. Thank God for you. Just gonna do a little bit. God bless you, sir.
You
look like a teenager. Thank you for your testimony.
A beautiful service. God bless everyone that is there.
Amen.
God bless. Beautiful service. Yeah.
God bless you. Very good to see you, Shereen Mom.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Well, blessed, highly favored, in spite of myself. Thank God for mercy and grace and abundance. Yes, sir.
Well, no.
Yeah, I would have had my camera, but I found out at the last 5 minutes they didn't have internet access.
Oh.
Otherwise, I would have gotten my mobile access. Yeah. But found out at the last minute. So that's why we're using your tablets.
Well, we appreciate it. We really do. Thank you.
Yes, we do. Good job videotaping and Zooming.
And I'm going to go take you to the other room where they're having refreshments. All right, we're traveling. We'll go into the reception room. There they are.
Did you see Brother Alfred? Alfred, Mother Jackson's son.
Oh, yes. Yes, ma'am. It's
not right, like, did you wear it comfortable to have it?
Sure.
God bless you, God.
Thank you.
I'm
All righty. I had to do what I had to do. Now I'm coming back around.
Taking your own fish, man.
Well, that's right. I don't know who to introduce yourself.
Stand up.
All right. I guess everybody else knows.
Well, everybody knows me. They know of me. I'll say it like
that. All right. That makes sense.
They know of me.
Well, I'm glad you're here.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right.
On the way. Hi. All right. Okay. Hi, everybody. That's for sure.
Oh my God.
Let me get your face. Hey. That's fine. Thank you for asking.
Hey.
Workaholic. Always. Good to be able to count on you. All right. Yeah. I'm going to turn this off. All right. Thank you for watching. I think. Oh, I didn't even recognize you. God bless you. Good to see you. Amen. No longer MIA. Well, I'm glad to hear that. I think I didn't know it was him. I'm telling you, I mean, impersonating our friends. We know. God bless you. God bless you, Wade. Amen.
I can't forget you either.
Amen. Thank God for you. All right, let me get out the way.
Wait. Thank you.
I got a bracelet. Let's see if you can see it. No, that's all right. I think I'll put it down here. There it is. So this is a bracelet that they're giving out.
I don't know
if you can see it. Anyway, all right. Okay. All right. Okay. Hello, everybody. I think I'm just going to put this on the table until the battery runs down. Amen. It's Sarah. Oh. I just want to show this. Okay, there's the program.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to open it up so you can see. That's the bad. Amen.
That's our in the car.
Okay.
I'm going to go to the next one.
No, I just keep bumping into people.
Pass it down. Maybe no more.
Warm, how are you?
Okay.
Fantastic.
Oh, that was beautiful. Thank you so much. And thank you for letting me say just a few words about dear Lottie.
Well, it didn't look like I could stop you.
I have to tell you, last night, I wrote out what I was going to say, and I read through it, and it was about 5 minutes. So I wrote to Lanitra, and I said, oh, it's about 5 minutes long. And she writes back, and she goes, keep it to two. So I tried.
Right.
So it all worked out.
Yeah, thank you very much. We have a long drive, so we're going to hit the road.
Yeah, okay. All right. Thank you so much.
Bye. Take care. Be safe.
Thank you. Thank you.
So get on the seat.
Now she said they weren't hers.
She tried to get. She sent the little boy to tell me she was going out. Right? And then I was watching. You did that on
the phone. I know. So no, 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 no
That's ready.
Oh, she gonna own them.
This is yours.
This one's mine.
I can tell. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
This is the van. Where's your brother? Running around.
Oh, keeps working.
Yeah. I know. I'm gonna kiss the dog.
This one right here. She felt like she was wrong. She
okay, grandmama. I'm gonna take care. Oh. I'm gonna take care. You sit right here. I don't want you to fall.
So you live in where?
I'm in Texas.
You're in Texas too. Okay.
I'm the reason they all came back.
That's what I remember. That's right. You moved to Texas.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Everybody followed everybody.
Okay, what part of Texas?
Dallas. Dallas.
Nothing.
It was cheap to live there, but not anymore.
Not anymore. So many folks have moved there.
Yeah,
we got.
And not in the other little cities.
One family.
Houston. Fort Worth.
They moved them.
Houston is about 4 hours away, so they are a little better priced, but it's not much.
Wow.
Yeah, it's just out your way. I apologize.
Oh, I thought I was going to take that home.
Oh, fiddlesticks. Well, let me put it back.
I think I can turn it off now, don't you?
Honestly. All right, there's two. And we want to thank you for viewing. At this time, I'm going to end the stream. God bless you. The idea is to upload it to YouTube sometime next week. I don't know exactly when, but there'll be a notification, I'm sure, from Sister Lanita. God bless. God bless in Jesus' name. Thank you.